mean, what am I? Oh, where's the dog?
No.
Wait. Oh, this.
No.
Hi. All right. How's everybody this Sunday morning? With my dog is rambunctious. I think because it was raining here in Southern California. Oh my gosh. Hi. Is that Terry and Stephanie? The dog is nutballs this morning. It took every ounce of my being to peel myself up out of bed and get ready this morning. Today, for those of you who are new to this and new to my living room, hi Steve, all you need is enough room to step forward, side, and back from wherever you're starting. If you have a mat, that is an added bonus. It's not entirely necessary, but you would like it if you have one. So, the other thing that we're going to do, I'm going to work barefoot. Class is called Barefoot Cardio Sculpt. And Stephanie, I'm playing your theme song. And either all you might also need, I can't even speak today, would be, hi Aerie, is a pair of smallish dumbbells. I'm using 5 pounds. You're welcome to use whatever you have on hand. You can use nothing. You could use water bottles. You could fill water bottles with something else. So that's what you have. So maybe a mat, maybe dumbbells. I like to keep a couple of towels nearby, and then also a beverage that is water in its Halloween costume of a wine glass. Hi guys. All right, if you're watching this later, which you wouldn't be right this minute, but if later on you're watching this on my YouTube fitness channel, thank you so much for subscribing and liking the videos and sharing, telling a friend. That's how we grow this whole beast that is starting to feel pretty permanent. No grumblings of gyms opening. So if you are wondering how you get to this channel and you're on my Instagram or my IGTV, there's a link in my Instagram profile in my bio to this thing. And thank you to everybody who's been able to throw a donation into my Venmo or PayPal. Know that I really appreciate it, and I know a lot of us in entertainment are still severely unemployed. So if you're one of those people, don't sweat it. Just do your thing, get sweaty and stay fit so you can fit in the next costume. All right, having said all that, if you have any sort of injury, dog has his little chew stick. If you have any kind of an injury, please stay with the first or second level of all the intervals that I do later in the class. And then if you have seen a doctor for an injury, make sure that you have been cleared to do this kind of thing, because I wouldn't want you to get hurt. This is a disgusting chew stick, which he's not all that interested in today. So I'm gonna throw that onto his bed. Didn't really care. All right, so let's get started. You'll stand up. Make sure that you have room around you and that you're not gonna run into things. We're gonna start laterally. So you'll start with your feet wider than your hips if you're using a mat, sort of on the edges of your mat. It's a gray Sunday here this morning. 10 toes towards me, your knees are straight but they're not locked. Bring your arms up, shoulders down, but fingertips reaching straight up. Hips under your shoulders, your feet are not under your hips today. Holding yourself straight up and down, perpendicular to your floor and ceiling. Rotate your left toes towards the left side of the room. Bend your left knee, take your arms out to the side, come back up to the center, other side on your right, and up. In the center, you'll fold, grab your elbows, lift your tailbone up and unroll. Bring your arms up, let's do it again. To your left for two, and up, over to your right. One, two, center, fold over, grab your elbows, unroll. This time at the top, feet under your hips. Forward fold, either grab your elbows or let your hands fall to the floor. Either way, you'll straighten your left leg and bend your right knee. Sitting into your left hip, all of your toes can wiggle. Change sides, straighten your right leg and bend your left knee. Sitting into your right hip. And bend both knees, let your head hang. Lift your tailbone up, unroll, one bone at a time, at the top, Roll your shoulders down and back. Both arms come up. Forward fold, unroll. Lift your tailbone up and unroll. Let's do it again. Both arms up. This time, hold your fold either with your elbows being held or hands to the floor. Wiggle on your toes. Keep both knees bent the same amount. Your left elbow can come up slowly. One, two, and back down. This time, maybe you reach your arm up. Single count either way. So elbow or full extension. Two more. Right side, slow motion. Elbow lifts up. And this time, maybe your whole arm comes up. And single counts either level. Elbow or full arm extension. Two more. And hold your fold. Your tailbone lifts up. Your head hangs. Unroll. Three, two. Both arms come up. Forward fold. Tailbone lifts. Unroll. This time on your fold, you'll bend both knees far enough to get your hands to the floor. Step your feet back and find your downward facing dog. Pressing your heels into the floor. Your palms press into the floor. Just looks like an upside down V. With your tailbone lifting up to where the wall meets the ceiling behind you. And lower your hips to plank. You can hold here, or at any point you can lower your knees. If your knees are on the floor, your next progression is to lift up to plank. Once you're here, you have an option to rock forward and back. Let's do four more, either holding or rocking forward and back. Last two, then hold any plank and lift your tailbone up to a down dog. And shift your weight over to your right hand and foot and take your left leg up, only far enough to feel the stretch behind your right leg. You can stay right here or bend your left knee and open your left hip. I forgot to mention the after party today. If you took the bend in rotation, straighten back out to your three-legged dog. You can stay right here or lower your hips and bring your left knee to your left elbow. If you came down here, go back up. You can stay right here or come with me, lower down. One, two, and back up. Hi, Ellen. Lower for two and up. One more. And hold your three-legged dog. Both feet to the floor. Find your down dog in the middle. Pressing your heels into the floor. Shift your weight over to your left hand and foot. Take your right leg up until you feel the stretch behind your left leg. You can stay right here or bend your right knee and open your right hip. If you took the bend in rotation, straighten back out to your three-legged dog. You can stay here or lower your hips and bring your right knee to your right elbow. If you came down here, go back up. You can stay in your three-legged dog or come with me, lower one, two, and up. Again, lower for two, one more, and hold your three-legged dog, and both feet to the floor, down dog in the middle, then lower your hips to plank. You can stay here or lower your knees. Either way, try to bring your right leg up near your right hand. So you can wiggle your front toes. You can stay here. Maybe you touch your knee. Your back knee is welcome to be on the floor. Today, maybe you reach back in a circular motion. If you did, come back to the floor, engage your core, step to plank. Let's just walk through it on the left. Step your left foot forward. Can you wiggle your left toes? Maybe your right knee finds the floor. Maybe you touch your knee. Maybe you reach back in a circular motion. Either way, both hands to the floor. Engage your core. Step back to plank. You have a lot of options. Try it a little faster. Step, maybe you circle, maybe you touch your knee, maybe you go slower than I am. Maybe you take the circle. Either way, your core is engaged and you are breathing in and out. And then hold any plank if your knees are still up. Now's the time to put them down. Release your feet, hips to your heels. Child's pose, pressing your chest through your shoulders. Round your back up until you're in a modified plank. That's just hands underneath your shoulders. Knees on the floor, release your feet, hold here, or bend your elbows a little bit. They'll touch your rib cage. Maybe you go further or further. Either way, press the floor away from you and hips to your heels. Let's come back up to a modified plank. It sounds like I ate a frog this morning. So know that in this position, when you bend your elbows, the further you bend them, the more resistance you're giving yourself. So think of it as dumbbells. Small dumbbell, medium, heavy dumbbell, straighten up and hips to your heels. So let's walk through to make it flow. Round up and hold here or bend a little or a lot. Straighten back up. Child pose, let's make it flow. Here we go. Round up, hold or bend. Child pose, round, hold or bend. Same thing, round, hold or bend. We'll go twice more from here. Round, hold or bend. Last one. This time, modified plank hold. When you get here, tuck your toes, push down to find your down dog. Lower your knees, release your feet. Hips to your heels, make that flow. Round up, down dog. Lower your knees, child's pose. Same thing, round, press. Lower your knees. One more time through. Round, push down. This time, modified plank and hold it here. Squeeze under your armpits, tuck your toes. Maybe you stay here, maybe you lift your knees. If you lifted your knees, shift your weight to your left hand and foot, bring your right knee into your chest. If you came here with me, try to cross your right leg under your left leg. You can hold here, or you can bend, straight, and hold. Come back to the center. Feel free to put your knees down at any point. If you're up here and you want to shift your weight to your right hand and foot, do that. Maybe bring your left knee in, maybe cross it under, hold here, or bend, straighten. Two more. And hold. If you cross the leg underneath, bring it back to plank. From any plank, knees down or not, lift your tailbone up. Down dog. Walk your feet up towards your hands. Forward fold, let your head hang. Lift your tailbone up. Unroll, stacking your spine at the top. Adjust your outfit. Grab a sip of whatever you brought to drink. Water in a wine glass. All right, so now you're gonna pick up your resistance. Adjust your tights. I'm using fives. You can use whatever you like. I'm gonna scoop this back. I really shouldn't be adjusting my scenery, but you know. All right, shoulders down and back. Feet under your hips, hips under your shoulders, knees are soft. Thumbs towards me, bicep curl on your left and your right. Easy enough, you'll try to get a full extension without locking your elbows. So lift and lower. Lift. One more, then both arms together here. So the after party, since we're sort of hitting lots of things in this workout today, we're doing all of our upper body. We'll get plenty of cardio. So the after party today will be extra core, lots of extra core, and a little extra stretch. Keep your curl, maybe your left knee steps back, or your foot steps back. Your knee will bend. Your knee cannot step back. Nice little rehearsal lunge to the back. One more, keep your curl, feet stay here. Up and lower. Keep your curl, but take your feet wide with your toes to the corners. Hips underneath your shoulders. As you curl, sink your hips down, up, pushing into the floor to come up. So sink, press. We'll slow it down. Two counts to get there, one. Two, push down to come up. So last night, I acted sort of like a real person, and I went outside with a mask to an outside restaurant with some friends from college. It was a long time ago. Hadn't seen two of them in many, many years. Single counts here. We sat outside. We had a drink. It wasn't water in a wine glass. And I'm paying for it today. Two more just like this. One more. Now halfway from the top. So half extend just to the halfway. One more. All the way down, halfway up. So sink to the half, then full range, single count, sink, press. That press is into the floor with your feet. Slow it down, three counts to get there. So three, two, one to come up. These dumbbells should start to feel heavy right about now. And three, two, one more just like that. In three, two, let's reverse, one down, three to come up. Same thing, sink, two, three, twice more, sink, two, three, last one, sink, two, three, single count, sink, push into the floor to come up, just two more, then we'll go halfway down and hold here, little pulses. Can you wiggle your toes? Can you bring your knuckles towards me? Then rotate out at the shoulders as you pulse. This time, hold it out to the side, hold. Maybe your heels come up. Maybe extend your arms out to a V. Straighten your legs, hold here. Rotate your thumbs so they're towards me. Bend both knees, lower your heels. Bring your dumbbells down to your shoulders. Turn your toes towards me. Then sink down, press up. So that press is on a diagonal to where the wall meets the ceiling in front of you. Sink. Push into the floor with your feet. Sink. Press. Sink. Four more like that. So four, three, two, last one. Bring the arms down. Feet under your hips. Shoulder blades pinch together. Release. I feel that I have a rogue curl getting out of my ponytail. Bouncing around like a cheerleading competition. Four, three, your shoulder blades look like this. They go together. Next time, hold them back so you're retracting here. Bend both knees, wiggle your toes. Bend your elbows so they're facing behind you. Then hinge at your hip. Extend your arms and back to the hip. Extend to the hip. Extend. This is your move. Can you wiggle your toes? Is your spine extended? Single count here. It's up and out. In four, three, we'll go three times and hold. So it's three, two, hold your extension to the glutes. Three, two, extend to the glutes again. And three, two, extend again. Let's do that twice more. So three, two, extend last time. Three, two, hold your extension. Rotate your palms towards the ceiling. Look like this. And then pulse up, up, eight to go. Extend your arms and your spine. Wiggle your toes and pulse. Three, two, come up. Shoulders down and back. Both arms up. Feet wide, just your left arm comes up. Right arm hangs down. Just bend your elbow under your left for two. Maybe you sink your hips. One, two, extend. One more slowly. One, two, single count. So bend, extend. Try and keep your left elbow perpendicular to the floor. Four, three, last one. Hold it up. Change sides. Right arm comes up, wiggle your toes. Slow motion, bend your elbow. Now sink your hips. One, two, one more slowly. Elbow stays facing the ceiling. Single, bend, extend. Hips under your shoulders. You're breathing in and out. You're thinking of at least one thing that is worse than what we're doing. Four to go from here. Four, pushing into the floor to come up. Once more, hold your right arm up, bring it down, shoulders down and back. Wiggle your toes, both arms come up together. Hold your dumbbells together at the top, wiggle your toes. Now both elbows bend and extend, sink your hips. One, two, push down to come up. One, two, single count. So bend, press. Pushing into the floor to come up. Final four to finish the set. Four, press down. Three, two, hold everything up. Bring your arms down, shoulders down and back. Round your elbows, thumbs face each other. Wiggle your toes. Bring your elbows up and lower. Sink your hips. One, two, single counts right here. So sink, push down. We'll do four more just like that. Sink, push against the floor. Two more, hold it down. Little pulses here. Can you wiggle your toes? Are your elbows higher than your hands? I ask that. But are you in front of a mirror? And could you really know? So just really try to feel your elbows round. Three, two, hold, come up. Feet parallel, squats here. Sink, squeeze your glutes by pushing down through your feet. Squeeze at the top. Thumbs and dumbbells face the corners. As you squat, lift your thumbs up. Thumbs up, push down. Thumbs up, push into the floor. Do it again, sink, press down. Sink, press. I think I might be finally waking up. How about you guys? And sink, push down, thumbs up. Final four, so four, push, three. One more, and just a squat here. Sink, squeeze your glutes. Two more, hold your squat. Thumbs are facing each other. Elbows come back. Your shoulder blades pinch together. Your dumbbells meet at your hips. They don't meet, they get to your hips. Extend your arms down. Two counts to get there. One, two, single count. Row, so it's a narrow row. You want to feel your shoulder blades pinch together. Toes are able to wiggle. Elbows go straight back. One more. And come up and squat here. Remember that part? Two more. Hold your squat. This time round your elbows. Back fly. Lower so your elbows lift, your arms are rounded. Single count. So lift and lower. You're breathing in and out. Long spine. Four and three. On the last one. You'll hold here. Tailbone lifts up. Let your head hang, unroll at the top. Shoulders down and back, squats here. So we'll put those two moves together. The narrow row and the back fly. Hold your squat, narrow row, back fly once. One more row, come out of your squat. Do it again. Squat, hold, narrow row, back fly, row. Yep. Squat, let's do it again. So squat, row, fly, row once, come up. Let's do it again. So feel your shoulder blades hinge together on the narrow row, right here. Keep it going, squat. Row, fly, another row. Last time, when you get to your fly, hold your arms up, little pulses up. You're welcome. Breathing in and out. Long spine, rounded elbows. In four, three, two, forward fold.
Lift your tailbone up, hang on to your dumbbells, roll up. At the top,
circle your wrists. Two, three, reverse your circle. In four, three, now little curls here. Just little curls with your wrists. Four more in one, two, three, reverse your curl, make it an extension. These wrists are important. And they're your texting muscles. And release. Set your dumbbells down. Grab a sip of whatever you're drinking this Sunday morning. Alrighty. Feet parallel underneath your hips. Palms together, squats here. So sink. Push down to squeeze your glutes. Yes, I have a rogue curl that has escaped the ponytail holder. Well, it just still look a lot like Cindy Brady. I'll try to tuck it in, but I know it won't stay. Thank you to anybody who got my Cindy Brady reference. Touch your knees, knuckles up. So sink, knuckles up. Again. Four to go, like that. So remember to push against the floor to come up. Two more. And palms together. So keep that in your head. Two more squats, wiggle your toes. Left leg, step that one time. Just step to the right. Just a lateral step. Maybe you give it a little sink in the hips. So sink, maybe the arms go down in a V. Upside down V, together. Four to go. So four, three, two, center, squat, touch your knees. Four, knuckles up. Push into the floor to squeeze your glutes. One more, left leg steps out, maybe you sink. Four, together, three, together, two, squat, touch your knees. Four, up, three, one more, step out left, right here. Four, together, push against the floor to come up. And parallel squat, here it is. Four, up. Three, we'll do one more set. Out to the side, left side steps. Four, three, two, center, parallel squat. Four, press. Three, two, hold your last position here. Try to lift your heels and balance. Extend your fingertips up to the ceiling. Engage your core. That just means pulling your belly button in towards your spine. Everything's stacked up. Try to find a squat. Takes your booty out of the stack, but your shoulders now line up over your knees and your booty's out. Fingertips counterbalance the booty. Lower your heels, wiggle your toes, palms together. Push down to come up, squeeze your glutes, and then squat. All right, make sure you have room on the side. We're gonna move laterally. We're also gonna move a little bit in front. So you sort of wanna be in the middle of your space. Two more. Left leg, slow motion, lateral lunge. Do steps inside and bend. Push down to come up. Try it again. One, two, single counts here. So step, push off the floor, or push down into the floor. One more. Diagonally back with the left leg, so sink your hips. Push down the tap, same thing. One, two, single count. Two, sink, press. Two more, easy enough. Keep that in your head, squats here. We'll work it through on the other side. Two more, right side, slow motion, lateral lunge. Bend the outside leg, press off, let's do it again slowly. One, two, single count here. So out, press, bend, press. Push against, once more, slow motion, right leg diagonally back behind you, tap it in the center, again, slowly, single count here, down, press against the floor, two more, and then back to just the squat here, so keep that in your head, taking a little step back, left leg, step forward once, back and right, easy enough. As you step forward, your back heel is a little lift off the floor. Maybe bend both knees, bend. Press against the floor to come up. So think about pushing down to come up. Easy enough. Let's do four more like that. So it's four, three, two, just the squat right here. Think, squeeze, so we have those three pieces. Lateral, diagonal, forward, yes? We'll do it in single count, just the lateral and the diagonal to the left. Again, two more here, one more, diagonally back, sink, four, touch, three, touch, two, one more, forward here, forward, same leg, forward, two more, same leg. Last one, squat here. All right, let's do that much on the right side. Let's scoot a little forward. Right leg, lateral lunge for four. Press against the floor, two more. Diagonally back, right leg. Sink, tap, sink, tap. One more, here we go, forward, just on the right. Forward, press against the floor, one more, and squats right here, almost tipped over. So here's what's gonna happen. We've done both sides, we know how it works. We'll do just the left side, lateral lunge, diagonally back lunge, two forward on the same left leg, so we'll hold. Yup, left side. Here we go, lateral lunge, again, diagonally back, and then forward twice, same leg, left, again, hold your balance, yes, shake it out, squat here. We'll do the same thing on your right, then we're gonna add on to that. One more, here we go, right side, lateral lunge, two times, again, diagonally back, forward lunge, up, again. Squats here. Touch your knees, knuckles up. Can we do one of each of those? On your left, one more squat here. Here we go, lateral, diagonal. Forward, balance up, balance. Shake it out, left side, or right side. Diagonal, forward, balance up, balance. Here we go, left side. Lateral, diagonal. Forward, balance. Shake it out. Right side. Lateral, diagonal, forward, balance. Just squats here. So that's the beginning of it. Here's what's gonna happen. Palms together. We do the left side repeatedly. So we go lateral, diagonal, forward, lateral, diagonal, forward, and we hold, yes. Here we go, left side, lateral, diagonal, forward, balance, hold. Here we go on your left. So lateral, diagonal, forward, balance, hold. Again, left, diagonal, forward, hold. Do it again, lateral, diagonal, forward. You can just let your arms swing or hold them here. Last time. Lateral, diagonal, forward, balance, palms together. Take your left knee straight to the floor, then back behind you. Flex your back foot and pulse. Take your arms out to the side. Bring them up to a V. So your left knee is behind you. Your left foot is flexed. You're pulsing like you're trying to put a footprint up to where the wall meets the ceiling behind you. 8, 7, 6, 4 to go in 4, 3, 2 parallel squats. 4, up. We'll do the same thing on your left side in 4 squats. So 4, push down. 3, 2, here we go. Right side, lateral lunge. Diagonal, you can keep your palms together, forward, or let your arms swing. Balance, right side. Lateral, diagonal, forward, balance. You can tap or balance each time. Balance or tap, forward, balance or tap. Let's do it again. Lateral, diagonal, tap or balance. Let's go one more time to the right. So lateral, balance maybe. Try to balance here. Woo. Palms together, knees straight down, then knee behind you. I'm gonna turn a little bit so you can see it. So knee behind you, flex your foot and palm. Like you're trying to put a footprint up to where the wall meets the ceiling behind you. Take your arms up in a circle. Keep your pulse. You want to feel your hamstring barking at you. Palms together. Shoulders down, chest up. 4 more to go. 4, 3, 2, shake it out. Parallel squats. Keep your squat, but take your feet wide. Toes towards knee. Reach down. Pull up. Press in the middle of your feet into the floor. I rarely throw in a balance like that in the middle of the cardio, but I figured, why not? So sink, press. You can always work here for this next interval. You can even bring your hands here if you're getting out of breath. Otherwise, you'll come with me, hands to the floor, left leg reaches back behind you like we did in our runner stretch, back to wide, come up, squats here. So you can reach and pull, or palms together, or hands on your legs. Or come with me, hands down, right leg reaches back to your runner's lunge, back to wide, push down, roll up, squats here, sink, reach. We're not gonna stop in between, both sides, hands down, left leg goes back, reach back, wide, come up, sink, reach back. If the touching the floor is too crazy for you and your back, don't do it. You can work here. Same thing. Hands down. Left leg. If you're working your legs back, maybe you reach the opposite arm straight up to the ceiling. Remembering that on the way up, you're not letting your back bring you up. You're pushing down through your feet. Right here. Push down to come up. Your back is along for the ride. But the main source of your force, ooh, I made a rhyme, I should be a rapper, is pushing down through your feet. Push down right there. Sink, press, down to come up. Sink, reach, push down to come up. We'll do one more time, each side here. So step, reach, one more. Just the squat, palms together. Easy enough. Alrighty, catch a breath, grab a sip of whatever you're drinking if you need to. Then come right back here, toes facing knee, reach down, pull up. But the pull up is really driven by push down, yes? 4 to go, so 4, press down. 3, 2, hold at the top, palms together, left arm and up, right arm. Knee stays slightly bent. Maybe with a bent knee, you let your core lean by reaching over. Let's do 4 more like that. So 4, 3, 2, wide squat, reach down, push down to pull up. 2 more. Here we go, left side, reach down with bent knees for 4 and up, 3 and up. Easy enough, hop or pedal right here. So you can pedal with one foot always in contact with the floor, or you can hop. Here's where my hair falls apart. Either way, step or jump out, pedal, step or hop, jump, cross, beat. Guess it's time to go to Target and get a new pack of ponytail holders. Four, press, three, two, hold your squat here. Reach, push down to pull up. One more, reach down on your left, knees stay bent to the right. So this happens at the waist. One more, hop or pedal here. Hop or pedal, step or jump. Two more, wide reach and pull, squat, sink, push down to reach. One more, left side, bent knees, work from the waist, and over, again. One more, hop or pedal here, four, or three, two, wide squat, reach and pull, push down to come up. Two more, left side, reach down for four and up. Three, two, last set, hop or pedal for four, three, two, wide squat, reach and pull, four, push down. One more, left arm, knees are bent, you move from the waist. Two more, just hop or pedal here, no jump to the side. Let your shoulders shake out, in four, three, two, feet parallel squat. Step a little bit back, you want to have room in front of you. Palms together, weight in the middle of your feet, two more. Left leg, step forward once, and then your right. You know this, we did it already. Your back heel comes up, make it a lunge. Sink, push down to come up. Cactus arms, arms down, or goal pose. Cactus, 90 degrees, whatever you want to call them. Now two on the left. So lunge, straighten, lunge, back, lunge. Straighten, lunge, step back. Push into the floor and find your straight. Lunge. Now you have an option, when you straighten, to lean forward at your hip. So lunge, lean, or not. If that makes you nuts, don't do that part. Now, you're gonna lean, and you're like, that's not enough. Option to lift your back leg. Dog on the deck. Again, so I'm gonna take my palms together on the lunge lean, up, together, bend, and up. Lunge, together, check it out. Arms up, so lunge, lean, lunge, up. Easy enough. Let's do it again, lunge. Any form of this interval will do. Lunge, lean maybe your leg lifts. One more each way. Lunge. Lean. Last one. Squat, touch your knees. Four. Up if you were back. Step forward. One more. Palms together. Sink. We're right to where we started this section. Left leg. Step back one time. Step. Right leg. This is your pattern. It's easy enough. Maybe you work here, maybe you sink your hips, sink down, push into the floor to come up. So it's slightly turned out. You can call it a sumo squat. If you've had any ballet, you can call it a second position plié, and you don't have to call it anything really. Just make sure you're in the right position if you're sinking your hips. Maybe you reach up behind you. Reach and up. Reach up. You push into the floor to come up. Sink. Press down to come up. Sink. Push against the floor. The floor is your own personal leg press. It weighs as much as you do. What? Yep. because you are pressing your own weight against it. If we were in a real class, well, it is a real class, but if we were a person, I would make somebody give me the scientific theory for that. What? An equal and opposite, what? You guys know it. One more. Feet parallel, squats here. One more short interval before we go to the floor. Take your toes and feet to the corners. Sink, press, cross your forearms. For those of you who work out with me all the time, we're doing the short version of this. Two more here. Maybe your arms go out to a V and cross up over your head. Right there. And out to a V. Sink. Cross. Up tempo if you're ready. Cross. Open. You can work here, or maybe your heels lift as your arms cross. And lift. If you're lifting your heels, maybe you press down, get a little air. One more, right arm swings left. Center, other way. This is your pattern. Or you can lean over, get a little leg lift behind you. Let's do four more like that. So any level, two more. Center, jump or not. So here, or heel lift or jump. Again, right arm swings left. Upright or lean and lift. Center, jump or not. Four, three, two more. Palms together. Sink, press. Two more like that. Feet parallel. Inhale, reach up. Hands on your legs. Round your back. Then release your back. Round again. Release this time. Come all the way up. Grab a towel and whatever you're drinking. And keep one dumbbell at the ready for our core. Ooh, man. Feeling every bit of my virtue certificate today. All 162 years of it. All right. It's like how lazy like I was when I towel myself off. All right, so I'm turning sideways. You don't have to, but know that when I'm here, most of you know this, that when I cue front and back, I mean the arm or leg closest to me, and then of course the one furthest away. All right, grab one dumbbell. If you weren't working with dumbbells, you can also grab your towel and pull it tight. If you have a dumbbell, grab that. Sit up tall with your knees bent. Your dumbbell is gonna sit in your palm and then wrap your thumbs around the top and then lift your elbows. So if you're holding a big round deep ball from here, curl down and up to your start. Do curl halfway. Now when you curl down, you're engaging the front of your core, and as you come up, you extend and you engage the back of your core. Maybe your dumbbell lifts up on a diagonal as you curl down. So curl, maybe lift, up, again. Curl, lift, again, curl, lift. Same thing. So the dumbbell kind of forces you to engage your lat, the muscles that are along the side of your body. Curl, lift. One more. Curl, lift. Keep your curl, but bring your dumbbell into your chest. So your elbows are out to the side. Try to keep your elbows lifted instead of doing this. Because if you do this, you'll get an engagement of your deltoids, your shoulders. And I know it's cooling off, but you might always want to be tank top ready. Since it looks like we are going to be staying inside for the holidays, maybe you want to be sleeveless. I don't know. Curl down and hold. Hold it here. Maybe you rotate towards me and center. Away from me, towards me. Now as you rotate, maybe you bring your opposite knee. You lift from your hips so your knee stays at 90 degrees. Lift
Let's do it again. Four, three, two, double pulse at the top. One, two, one, two, one, two. Let's do four more like that. So it's four, breathing in and out. Once more, and come up. Set your dumbbell down. Knees can be slightly bent or straight. Round over. You'll release your low back. Actively separate your shoulder blades. Chin to your chest. Inhale. On your exhale, let both feet bring your eyes up, and then your shoulders, and then your body. And as you come up, your knees can be bent or straight. I'm gonna scoot forward so I don't disappear. Tuck your hips, fingertips out to the side to help you roll down. When you're all the way there, bring your knees into your chest and rock your knees side to side. Ooh. I did a lot of exercise yesterday that I don't normally do. My body's sort of in shock. It was all pre going out with my college friends, which is a lot different than it was when we were in college and went out. We just sat peacefully on a patio. Alrighty, come back to the center. Feet on the floor. And in the after party, I will continue what I discussed in the after party on Friday. What's this? Alright, heels next to your booty, palms next to your hips. Tuck your hips, push your feet down, lift your hips up until you find a diagonal line from your shoulders through your hips and to your knees. Hold here. Can you wiggle your toes? Maybe you lace your fingers underneath and scoot your shoulder blades closer together, breathing all the way in and all the way out. You should feel this in your glutes and your hamstrings. Unlace, roll down, bring your knees into your chest. We're not done with your core. In the after party, we're really gonna hit the core hard. All right, untuck your hips so your belly button's level to your pelvic bone. 90 degrees at the hip and the knee. Calves parallel to the floor. Fingertips behind your ears. Yep. Maybe this is enough for you and you stay here. Or you can extend your back leg to the wall in front of you. Squeeze underneath your back armpit. Lift your back shoulder blade off the floor. Let your elbows fall away from your face. Four counts to change. Four, three, two. You're there on one. Change four. Three, now two counts to make the change. One, two. So focus on keeping your incoming leg at 90 degrees and not letting it come too far into the chest. Then focus on keeping your elbow away from your face so that you're not inadvertently wrapping it around right there. Keep it out to the side. Single counts here. Lift in your perfect technique. 90 degrees of the hip and the knee, elbow away from the face. You engage underneath your armpit to lift your shoulder blade off the floor. Three, double pulse at the top. One, two, where's your elbow? One, two, four more just like that. Four, pulse. Three, last two, then eight singles to finish. What? Eight, seven, six, final four, three, two, release knees to your chest. Just give a little rock side to side and pull them in. Oh boy, dog in the house. Hold the center, both feet on the floor. Extend your front leg up until you feel the stretch behind it. Your back leg can stay where it is or it can walk down to find your point of flexibility. Either way, flex your front foot, bend the knee to the chest, extend up again. Flex, bend. Are your shoulder blades on the floor and not lifted? Hold your leg up. Doesn't have to be straight, you just want to feel it behind. Take your front arm on the inside of your front leg. Open the leg towards me just far enough to feel the stretch on the inside of the leg. Press your back hip to the floor. Flex both feet. Push your heels out to the walls. And then bend your front knee to the center. Front arm towards me. Back arm across your bent knee. And your knee goes over, maybe across your dog. Or why is this whole house? He has to park on my mat. And come back to the center. Change sides, front arm forward. Extend your back leg up until you feel the stretch behind it. Remember, your front leg can stay where it is, or it can walk out to some other mysterious point of flexibility. Flex your back foot, bend through the chest, send the heel up, do it again, flex, bend, drive the heel up once more, so flex, bend, hold your extension wherever that is, back arm on the inside of the back leg, and open the leg to the side, but only far enough to feel the stretch on the inside. Front hip presses into the floor. My watch thinks I was talking to it. Flex both feet. Press your heels out to the wall. Now remember to breathe. Then bend your back knee to the center. Back arm reaches out to the side. Front arm across your knee and the knee rotates towards me. Breathing all the way in and out. Reaching your back fingertips out and come back to the center. This time, you'll bring both knees into the chest before you flip over. Cross one leg over the other. Try to grab your calves, maybe your feet, and pull in towards your chest. Whichever leg is on top, you're gonna feel this in that booty. So my front leg is on top, and when I pull towards my chest, it gets right deep in the booty. So if you're having any sort of sciatica stuff, that's how deep the stretch should get. You're breathing all the way in and all the way out. And then release, change sides. Other leg on top. My legs are short, it's hard for me to do this. Grab your calves or your ankles, depending on your flexibility, the length of your legs. Pull in. So you're just trying to really get whatever leg is on top, some pressure against it, and then into the chest. You'll feel this in the opposite booty. Breathing all the way in and out. I don't know what purpose my dog is serving as a prop right now. And then release. Both feet on the floor. Flip over onto your stomach. Arms and legs extended. Take your front arm, reach around, grab where your shoelaces would be. Pull your heel to your hip, hip to the floor. You'll feel this on the front side of your leg, your quadricep. And release, change sides. Reach around with your back arm, grab where your shoelaces would be. Heel to the hip, hip to the floor. If you can, keep it there. And bring your front arm back around. If you're not quite here, work on this. And then once you're here, you can push your feet into your hands and try to lift your knees and maybe lift your chest. Oh, my quads are madly. And release. Hands on the side of your chest. Press your chest up, hips to your heels. Child's pose, pressing your chest through your shoulders. And round your back up to a tabletop. Hands underneath your shoulders, tuck your toes, round your back, push down to lift your knees and tailbone up, walk your feet up towards your hands, let your head hang, lift your tailbone up, and slowly unroll in 4, 3, 2, you did it, this class is done. After party, lots of abs, side, middle, a little extra stretch. Thanks for joining me on my mat in my living room with my dog. I'll either see you in 5 minutes or a day this week, maybe Monday, Wednesday, or Friday. Thanks, you guys.